All right, another 8 inches of snow last night out here in a trail run today. Trail running in the deep snow is tough. So if you ever get the chance to give it a try, great conditioning. I can see the deer were out here, but I haven't seen any human tracks yet. So beautiful day, got a little sunshine coming down, and we'll get in the run and we'll see you back at the gym.
A couple of quick stretches for the legs. I'm not going to run into it too deeply, but we'll go over some major parts of the leg. Hamstrings, back of the upper thigh. I find it easiest way, especially when you're out there in the trail, you don't really want to be sitting on the ground if you don't have to. So find the edge of a shelter or a log that's laying over, whatever you can, and throw one leg up there. Now when you're stretching that hamstring, not only stretch straight ahead, okay, just keep the knee relatively straight, let your back relax, lower your head towards your knee, but also take it to the side. So I'll reach my right hand out over my left leg, and that's going to stretch more on the inside of the hamstring. And then I'll reach it out, so my left leg is going way out to the side, and that'll stretch outside and up into the glute as well. So hit all three angles, straight ahead, to one side, to the other. Hold each one of these stretches for about a 10 count, 15 count, 20 count even optimally. You can do two or three sets of each one of these stretches. Quadriceps, a couple quick ways to stretch the quads. Simply for the quads, just pull up the foot behind you, balancing on one leg or holding on to something for balance. Okay, that's giving you a nice stretch down the head of the quadricep. Also, you can put the back leg back behind you. And by doing this, you're not only going to stretch the quadricep, but you keep that heel pressed into the ground, so you're getting a little bit of a calf stretch. And then you can also reach up and over the body and push that hip forward, and that's going to give you a stretch in the hip flexor and up through the ribs and the intercostals up in here, serratus, all those muscles up in there. Twist and reach across like that again. Holding that for a 15 to 20 count, doing two or three sets. Okay, that one was, that one last one was a good stretch for the calf raise, for the calf muscle. And also, I've got a barbell here. You can elevate this on a branch, a rock, or whatever when you're outdoors, and just get that heel as close to the object that you're elevating the front of the foot on as possible. Keep the knee straight and bring the hip and the rest of the body forward. This is another great way to stretch the calf muscle. Calves are really important to stretch because you're working the heck out of them every day. You can also roll onto the outside of the foot and stretch the side of the ankle like so. So I've got the pressure on the foot on the outside edge, so I'm rolling it out. You can also stretch the inside of the ankle, same way, put the inside edge and roll it that way. Okay? Now the front of, so we've covered the back and both sides. Now to stretch the front, tibialis anterior, the long muscle down the shin. You just drag that toe behind you and let the knee come forward, and you'll feel that stretch in the front of the shin and right down into the top of the foot. The tendons in the top of the foot, you'll feel stretching and everything. All those for that ankle are really important when you're out there hiking because, like I said, you're just giving a lot of abuse to that area of the body. So those are your main areas of the leg. Now, if you want to go up into the hip, again, you could throw that leg up on a log or the shelter or whatever, press down on the up on the inside of the knee. This is going to be working in the hip in here and also on the adductors on the inside of the thigh. I have very tight hips. So I feel this really tremendously in that hip right there. So again, working it there. And then you can bring that leg across and stretch the outside of the leg. This is gonna work a little bit of the ITB, the iliotibial band. Another way to work the iliotibial band, which a lot of people have problems with, I'm lucky I don't, is to cross the feet over, one foot over the other. This is gonna stretch the ITB, the iliotibial band, on the right leg, my right, looking at me, it looks like the left. And then just go into a toe touch. Just hang down, nice and slow, and you'll feel that stretch, not only in the hamstring on the left leg, but you'll feel it coming up through that right leg and ITB up into there. So these are some real basic stretches for the lower end. As we go along here, I'm going to show you a couple exercises down the road for upper body. And after we do those upper body exercises, then I'll show you some stretches for the upper body as well. Also going to be pretty important. But hit those 15, 20 seconds pop and 2-3 sets each, and that should help you out a lot. Thanks for watching.